friends niya. So makakain ka naman.
Thank you. paano yung settings ng ISO niya?
Let us all rise for the invocation to be followed by the Philippine National Anthem.
International stage. Isn't that fantastic? Give them another round of applause. It's a hard thing, huh? I've done it myself.
Mahirap yan. And you're here now.
And I'm here now because I'm too old.
No, you still look good. Well,
thank you very much.
We have these 23 male contenders over here, and within the night, we will be narrowing them down to the top 15 bachelors who will be given the chance to advance towards our top 8, which will compete, as you said a while ago, in international competitions.
And I've actually seen them backstage. And it's a tough field out there, you know? It's going to be difficult for our judges. And I'm glad we're up here.
Yes.
This is easier than what they're doing.
It is. I think so, too. All right, so let's settle down a bit. It is now time for us to hand out our first set of special awards.
Special awards, okay.
Yes. So how about we move over this side?
Yes, and you're looking lovely tonight. I didn't say it, but you're looking lovely.
I'm batting my eyes for you, Andrew.
I say that every year, so.
Thank you very much.
Okay. I mean it.
You mean it. Of course you should mean it.
Okay. I mean it.
Thank you. Okay. Alright, for the first award, for the first set of special awards, we have the Mr. Philippines Friendship Award.
Friendship Award, so that's pretty self-explanatory there. Friendly.
Friendly.
Okay.
And the winner of this were actually chosen by the candidates themselves as well.
Okay.
So for the Mr. Philippines Friendship Award, we have Eris John Palechabalay from Kabanatuan, Nueva Ecija, our bachelor number 5.
Yes. Don't they look good together? Congratulations. And we have another award for this special set. This is Mr. Philippines Photogenic Award, chosen by our official photographer, Mr. Wacho Gabinete,
who is here right now as well.
Okay. And the winner of Mr. Philippines Photogenic is from San Antonio, Nueva Ecija, Mark Anthony Beltran.
Bachelor number 22.
Give him a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, so congratulations to our winners. As a recap, we have Eris John Palencio Bonner from Kabanatuan Nueva Ecija as our Mr. Philippines Friendship Award.
Okay.
Awardee. And we have Mark Anthony Beltran from San Antonio Nueva Ecija as our Mr. Philippines Photogenic Award. So there you go, ladies and gents.
Congratulations. And now, let us meet the people who will decide which of our bachelors will represent the Philippines. Okay. Our first judge is Principal Basic Education Department, Systems Plus College Foundation, President of Angeles Association of Private Schools, Outstanding Educator awarded by Rotary Club of Angeles, and he's instrumental in making Systems Plus College Foundation as an outstanding private secondary school in Region 3, awarded by the Department of Education Region 3 Office. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Carlito Antonio.
Our next judge is a student from Systems Plus from the HRM Department, owner at Red Onions Bar and Resto and Bourgeois Hairdressing Spa, wearing the gown from Khaled Hot Couture, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Daisy Svensson.
Welcome, ma'am. Okay, our next judge is a friend of mine. He is the country's top independent and international pageant blogger who was voted one of the top 10 most influential personalities in Philippine pageantry. He is accredited media partner for Miss Universe, Binipini Pilipinas, Mundi ng Pilipinas, Miss Philippines Earth, and will be soon the social media specialist for Miss World Philippines. He is NormanNorman.com himself, Mr. Norman Tinio.
Chikamazing, owner of Black Diamond LCP Manila Model Management and owner of Fabrics Nation. He's also the owner of La Provence by Medi, House of Beauty, opening soon, and also one of our sponsors. We have as our fourth judge, Mr. Zawi Medi. Congratulations for being here, sir.
Yes, he seems to own a lot. Okay, our next judge. Wow. His creation took center stage at the prestigious Miss Universe Beauty Pageant held in Las Vegas in 2015 when Philippines Universe Pia Wurtzbach wore his creations as her national costume and evening gown. Ladies and gentlemen, the creator of iconic royal blue gown of Miss Universe Pia Wurtzbach and the designer, Mr. Albert Andrade.
We're down to our sixth judge, and I'm hearing so much. So all of these judges are really qualified to be here. Down to the sixth judge, we have the Mr. Glamour Student 1994, Mr. STI 1994, Mr. University 1997, Theater actor, CEO of Mountain Stream Trading Corporation, and the CEO of Montage Skin Science International. Ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome Mr. Andy Diokno Maranta.
Our next judge is former SGV Sigip Gores Velayos, accountant and controller of Toyota Dealers, managing partner of SVS and Associates CPAs, a CPA and a PhD graduate, mompreneur also. Please welcome Florita Santos.
For our eighth judge, she is the vice president of the Ultimate International Talent Group of Companies, the producer of the upcoming Chris Aquino show to be aired on April 9th. Watch out for that, guys. She's also a philanthropist. So ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome Rodora Pascual Morales.
Good evening, ma'am. Okay, our next judge is founder, co-owner of Sash Factor, accredited media organizations such as Miss Universe, Miss World, Miss International, and other prestigious male pageant competitions. Please welcome Brix Vera.
We have now completed our set of judges who has the very difficult task of choosing which among these 23 or which among later on the top 15 will be going on and going home.
Yes.
With the title.
It's going to be an interesting evening tonight. It's slightly different from last year, but of course the same principles behind everything. Is that correct, partner?
The same. It's the essence, of course, of the Mr. Philippines that we're looking for, or forward to looking for. So, last Sunday actually, Andrew, last April 2, the Mr. Philippines 2017 preliminary competition was also held here, but in a different area. So it was at the Systems Plus College Foundation Theater. And there, the swimwear festival costume and formal wear were already judged. And so for tonight, this is the night that we will be finding out who has gathered enough points throughout the competition to enter our elusive top 15.
Ooh, top 15. So for everyone's information, after the scores are tallied this evening, 14 bachelors will go on to the next round, and we will be choosing one more from audience participation and voting to make up the 15th candidate, okay?
Yeah, so
is that clear?
With the tickets that you guys bought to watch the show, you are also given the power to advance your favorite bachelor towards a spot in the top 15 semifinals.
Yes.
So for the final cut, only the top 8 men from the 15 will be chosen, and from the 8, the new batch of winners for the Mr. Philippines 2017 will be named.
Correct, and let me reiterate once again that after we've chosen the top 15, it will all be on an even starting from zero playing field, so they'll go back to zero for the next round, okay?
All right, so since all of that has been cleared out, We would once again want to thank our judges for taking on what would be an impossible challenge, no doubt.
Correct. We want to thank you, judges, for doing the difficult job of choosing our candidates. Let's give them another round of applause.
All right, so then I guess we have to put this show to a start. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you to the Mr. Philippines 2017 Proclamation Night. Arriba! And here to ignite the stage, we have one of the prize of the institution, the SPCF Salilahi Dance Crew.
Ha ha ha!
chiseled physique with Agusa Desu.
go really close to candidate number 16 there to get back on stage. And you actually touched him. You touched his oily body. How do you feel?
I touched him.
I can still see the oil now.
Yeah, I'm sweating. Oh my God. Of course, wearing the
wonderful... I managed to avoid.
Oh, Andrew. Of course, they're wearing the wonderful creations of Mr. Sunny Boy Mindo. And...
yes. Sunny Boy Mindo, give a round of applause. Thank you so much.
You can really see that they really worked hard for this, Andrew.
Yes, they have. They have.
Well,
good job. I'm not going to comment any further. You can comment on this part of the show this evening. Okay, let's cool down a little bit because we're going to award some more special awards to these bachelors. And the two awards for the set are Best in Swimwear and Jimmy Nikdao Style Award and Best Presentation, Video Presentation.
We have first the Best in Swimwear. And let me just say this first to you, Andrew. I can see that you can actually pull something off like this as well.
Maybe 10 years ago. 10 years ago now.
All right, so let's move forward. Best in Swimwear. The Best in Swimwear is Bachelor number...
I don't know. It's up to you. It's up to you. You can do
bachelor
this.
Bachelor number...
I'm trying not to look.
You cannot.
He's making me feel something I shouldn't.
Why did you go there? You actually can see them really well on that.
No. It's better for you to be closer.
Okay.
Okay, our next award is the Jimmy Nikdao Style Award. And the winner is... who? Okay, the winner is from Pangasinan. Bachelor number 21, Woody Andres Jr.
Of course, with Mr. Gemini Dow as well. So for the last award for this set of special awards, we have the Best Video Presentation, and this award goes to Bachelor number... it is you once again, Bachelor number 11, Denver Hernandez from the Filipino community of Italy. So there you have it, ladies and gents, folks, our Best in Swimwear is Bachelor number 11, Denver Hernandez from the Filipino community of Italy. He also garnered the Best in Video Presentation. And the Jimmy Nikdao Style Award goes to Bachelor number 21, Woody Andres Jr. from Pangasinan.
Congratulations, boys!
Once again, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Governor.
And now to offer everybody a powerful intermission number, we welcome on stage the outstanding SBCF Quintet. coming from the newest singing artist of ABS-CBN Star Music, the first Filipino given by Bruno Mars to revive his own composition, When I Was Your Man, the Gawa Filipino's most promising young artist, and the singing idol, LA Santos.
Thank you.
Oh, no. Fonbuena.
Once again, Pageant number 11, Denver Hernandez.
From the Filipino community of Italy, everybody. Which is the best in barong. So they did not wear their barong for tonight, but actually they have their photo shoots as well wearing them, and they can actually view it on Facebook. Yes. And speaking of Facebook, we are live in Sash Factor right at this very moment. So if you want to watch and you want your friends, your families to watch at home or anywhere that is or that has Wi-Fi or 3G,
yes, of course.
Can do so.
Okay. I just want to shout out to Mr. Sandoval. He's put about 50 comments on the live feed. So, Sandoval, how's it going?
Thank you very much.
We are Mr. live. Sandoval.
Okay, so the best in barong goes to.
Oh.
Bachelor number one, Alton Cayano from Agusan del Sur.
Fantastic. Okay, congratulations, candidate number one. Next, we're gonna award Mr. La Provence by Mehdi. Okay. Partner, who is the winner? Let us know now.
Okay, so the winner is Bachelor number. From Florida, Blanca Pampanga.
Congratulations, candidate number 12. Congratulations to you, sir. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, our next award is Smart Ambassador Award. Partner.
So for the Smart Ambassador Award, it is Bachelor number 17, Joshua Reginald Banatin, all the way from Laguna. So since this is the last set of special awards, we've been given more awards than usual throughout the night. And actually, we are down to our last award.
I think there's some screaming down here. What's going on, ladies? Okay. You're voting for this gentleman here. He also went to date with some of these ladies afterwards.
Later.
That's not official. That's unofficial.
Later. Okay. So the next award and the last award for this last set of special awards is the Face of Toledo Med Award.
Face of Toledo Med Award.
And actually, Toledo Med has a message for the organizers. They want to say thank you to the organizers for making Toledo Med as part of the Mr. Philippines family. And it is great. It is a great honor to be one of their co-sponsors, our co-sponsors for tonight. It was indeed a very successful event, and for the first time in history, the Toledo Med family would like to congratulate contestant number
10
from Dubai community as our ambassador, and now as the Toledo Med baby.
And I think this Sandoval that's on Sash Factor is a fan of candidate number 10, because he's like, Dubai, 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 Dubai. I'm like, never ending Dubai, Dubai, Dubai.
Oh, you've actually been looking at all the calls. That's really great on you.
Yeah, just I've been sitting down there going through the comments, watching the show
on
Sashback.
Slight
delay, 5 seconds. But nevertheless, fantastic. You're sharing this to the whole world.
Yes, it's really great. Such an honor, sir. Thank you very much. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, our winners for this set of special awards. Once again, the best informal wear is Bachelor number 11, Denver Hernandez from the Filipino community of Italy. Best Nick Marong, Bachelor Number 1, Aljun Kayawan from Agusan del Sur. Mr. La Provence by Medi, Bachelor Number 12, David Joshua Soledad from Florida Blanca, Pampanga. Smart Ambassador Award, Bachelor Number 17, Joshua Reginald Panatin from Laguna. And Bachelor Number 10, Ivan Darrow Francisco from Filipino Community of Dubai.
Give them a round of applause once again, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations.
Alright, so may we ask our winners to go back to their respective places once again. For now, we will be announcing our top 15.
Yes, this is one of the first milestones of the evening. It's so nerve-wracking. R23, as you mentioned, will go down to 15. Woo! And compete to be one of the top 8 in the next round. Okay. So, do we have...
They already gave me the results beforehand, so... I'm actually very nervous as well, since I've already met these guys. So...
You're nervous for them.
My heart...
Talaga lang. So,
okay. So, Andrew, let's do this.
Okay. In no particular order... Our first candidate is Bachelor Number 17 from Laguna, Joshua Reginald Banati.
Okay, so actually, the very first person that we should have called is the one who got the most audience votes. So this means, as you have seen on the screen, we have Batangas, Patrick Ian Cruz, Bachelor Number 3. He is automatically part of our top 15 as the Audience Choice Awardee.
Congratulations to you,
Ian. And also to Bachelor Number 17 from Laguna, Joshua Reginald Banatin. Okay, for the next Bachelor part of the top 15, we have Bachelor Number 11 from the Filipino community of Italy, Denver Hernandez.
Okay, joining these gentlemen here, all the way from close by, Bulacan, candidate number 4, James Alfred Ventura. Joining these 5 gentlemen, all the way from Cebu, candidate number 8, Virgilio Diego.
This is also the night for Bachelor Number 21, Woody Andres Jr. from Pangasinan.
Okay, going through Mr. Kayawan, candidate number 1.
Halfway through?
Yes.
And now, as part of the top 15, you are
our next candidate is from MICA San Antonio, candidate number 22, Mark Anthony Beltran.
To join these guys, we have Mark Ian Cavalin And now as part of our top 15 as well, you are in Bachelor number 60 from the
is from San Pablo Laguna, candidate number 24, Cyrus Morris.
All right, so I guess two more to go. From Florida Blanca.
Our next candidate is from Philcom Community Dubai, candidate number 10, Iwan Daryl Francisco.
All right, so there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. I guess they're 15 already. Can you count them, partner?
I don't think so.
Okay.
2, 4, 6, 8, 10. I think there's 14 there. I think we have one more.
Actually, guys, here's the thing, Andrew. We have a tie.
Really?
Really.
Okay.
For the last pot.
So how are we going to settle this?
Tie.
Should we decide?
Actually, they will be top 16 now since there is a tie. So the last pot goes to Bachelor number.
Top 16! Congratulations to you and commiserations to our other gentlemen.
So later on, you will be seeing our top 15 bachelors once again back on stage for the casual interview, which will be determining who will enter the top 8 and who will have to go through the dreaded question and answer portion as well. So right now,
do you have your bet, partner? Do you have your bet?
Oh, actually, all of them are good.
Bet mo, eh.
But why not? They are very much qualified, actually.
So black stays go.
It's hard to... I have it here near me. Why do I have to look anywhere else?
Wow.
Okay. So we have already announced our top 15, but for now, we want to look back on our winners from the past year.
Yes, we do.
So they have served the whole year 2016 to 2017 and represented themselves and the country with all their might and splendor for winning last year's Mr. Philippines 2016 competition.
Oh, splendor. Okay, so we begin with a video presentation from the Mr. Global Team 2017, Mr. Joaquin Rodolfo Rosalioso.
Not only being Mr. Global is a way to inspire the youth to use their voice or whatever emotions in their life to say. There are numerous ways and opportunities to give yourself and be a voice to the youth. Either fashion, showbiz, modeling, or being who you are is important because above all is what your advocacy and what is your voice trying to tell the youth. That is the most important. I myself did this because my opportunities were laid ahead for this pageant. And as you can see, I am Mr. Global Team, and I am inspiring you guys to you that my advocacy is an inclusion. And whatever it is you dream of and I try to aspire is your way of saying your voice to do anything that is good. I'd like to say to my supporters that I have given anything. But the most simplest thing I can say is thank you. From the moment I started visiting meetings, where people supported me through likes, sharing, that is important. That is enough for me. I don't need material things to support me. Just cheerfulness, I know in the back of my head what I'm meaning. There are people cheering for me and knowing that whether I win or lose, I did something great.
So ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome on stage the Mr. Global Team 2016, Joaquin Rodolfo Arceliosa. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome back on stage our top 15 or top 16 semi-finalists.
Oh, guys, are you excited? Are you still with us? Are you still awake? What time is it now, partner?
Have a watch.
And here they are.
I think we should go here.
Okay.
Because this is now the casual interview portion.
Okay. I thought we were going here to greet the audience on the left.
You can do that as well if you want.
Just broke me along.
So we have half of our top 16 finalists.
Okay.
Right now, and we call on our audience choice awardee.
Okay, candidate number three.
So it's Patrick Ian Cruz from...
Patrick Ian Cruz. How are you feeling tonight?
I'm so excited.
Okay, you look excited. And do you have a message for any of your fans out there this evening?
Thank you for continuing to support me in my dream to be the Mr. Philippines 2017.
Okay, why is it your dream? Out of all the dreams you could possibly have in the world, why is it your dream to be Mr. Philippines 2017?
It's my dream to be Mr. Philippines 2017 because I want to be a role model to everyone and I want to inspire people in doing good things. And that's why my dream is to be the Mr. Philippines 2017.
Okay, that's not your question, by the way, but very good. Okay, come here. That was just a bit of a practice for you. I'm so harsh. Just get him going. Okay. Thank you, very beautiful lady. You're so tall.
So it's been rolled?
Yes.
Okay, so we just actually want to hear what our top 16 opinion on several traits that a Mr. Philippine contender should have. So what he picked is Mr. Philippines should be respectful. So what is your take on that, Ian?
Sa tingin ko po, ang isang Mr. Philippines ay dapat respectful. Dahil siya ay titingnan ng maraming tao at ipapakita niya ang magagandang katangian ng isang tunay na Pilipino. Kaya po, sa tingin ko, ang isang tunay na Mr. Philippines ay dapat respectful. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ian.
Thank you very much. Candidate number three. Give him a round of applause. Okay.
So we now have bachelor number 17 from Laguna, Joshua. Supporters for tonight.
Yes. Is that your girlfriend?
No.
Oh, so it's a guy. Is that your boy? Just kidding. Okay, so how do you feel now you've made it this far?
I'm feeling grateful.
Grateful? Why grateful? Do you not think you deserve this?
I believe that being in the top 15 is something, is a really big achievement already. And I believe that I'll be eternally grateful for the judges and everyone who supported me.
Okay. Okay, sir. The scroll, like medieval times.
Okay, so it says here that the Mr. Philippines should treat everyone equally. So do you believe that as well?
I do believe that a Mr. Philippines should treat everyone equally because as a person and as a people of the world, we are all created equally by God, and that's why we should treat each other equally. Thank you.
Thank you, Joshua.
Thank you very much. So confident, young man.
Confident. What another trait that a Mr. Philippine contender should have.
Correct.
By the way, so now let's move forward to Denver Hernandez.
Denver Hernandez.
From the Filipino community of Italy.
Look at this man, like a GQ model, just emoting and everything.
With an eye.
Oh, there he is, he's smiling now.
So Denver, you're from Italy. And Italy, when we hear Italy, we think of pasta. Do you cook?
Yes, I do.
So what kind of pasta do you usually cook?
I cook carbonara, pasta asciutta, which is with more with the tomato sauce, and pasta al pesto, which is simple but tastes great.
And he has a fantastic accent.
Do you
love
hear
it.
That guy?
This guy's gonna know. He's guapo. He's smooth.
The accent.
He's got the accent.
Oh no, Andrew, you're falling in love.
Okay. Let's see what's between the ears. And I'll help you with this.
Okay, it says here that the Mr. Philippines should have a good heart. So what is your take on that?
Okay, I agree with that. And I think that Mr. Philippines should have a good heart because as an icon, he must show that you must have heart to your next, to your fellow, and you must show that you're kind. And so you can inspire each other. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Kennedy 911, and I know you're inspiring everyone tonight.
Okay. So moving forward, we have Bachelor number 4 from Bulacan, James Alfred Ventura.
Okay, he's brought his own bus of fans.
Like a boy next door type.
You're a tall man. I didn't realize from down there. What's your height?
I'm 6'1".
Six, you're at least one. He's 6'3 with the hair.
All right. So James, all the way from Bulacan.
Okay, here's the fishbowl.
Never thought someone would be taller than you. Stand straight. Okay.
Yes.
So it says here that the Mr. Philippines should be hardworking. Do you think that Mr. Philippines should be hardworking?
I believe that every one of us should be hardworking in different aspects of our lives. And earning the Mr. Philippines title got a lot of hard work to do. And I believe that if one earned the title of Mr. Philippines, I believe that he is really a hardworking person. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, candidate number 4.
James, everyone. And now we have Bachelor number 14 from General Trias Cavite, Lester Ventura. I like what he's wearing right now.
I like your outfit. It's like John Travolta inspired. Who made this?
Sir.
John Travolta himself?
No.
Okay. Who?
Sir Miguel.
Sir Miguel, okay. Big up to you, Sir Miguel.
So,
Saturday.
Once again, we have Lester, and for Lester, we have this trait. A Mr. Philippines should be a good role model.
Thank you. Ang pagiging Mr. Philippines ay isang nagsisilbing magandang asal. At ganda asal at di sorry may question.
Mr. Philippines should be a good role model.
Ang pagiging Philippines po ay bilang isang mabuting asal. Mabuting asal po at ito po ang pagiging role model po at ibibigay ko po ang aking advocacy bilang sagot, bibigay po ang aking advocacy bilang isang good role model po at ipagpamalakad kung pagbibigyan po ako ng platforma at pagbibigay boses po sa kabataan, yun po ang aking maibibigay po. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, candidate number 14.
And now we have Bachelor number 8, Virgilia Liego from Cebu.
From Cebu.
So from flowers, we now have butterflies over here.
Yes, I love it. Okay. How's everything going down south?
From down south, like, I never been there. Like, I live in Manila for almost a year, so I don't know what's going on there.
Okay, good representative. Here is the fishbowl.
All right, Virg.
Sorry, was that controversial? I take that back. Sorry.
Why don't you help me with this?
Yeah, let's be a good role model.
Okay, it says here that a Mr. Philippines should have a good sense of humor. Just like you, Andrew. Okay.
I got a bad sense of humor.
Oh, well, thank you for that. I'm going to start it. Mr. Philippines should be a man. A man is a chivalry of a knight, a guardian of a father, or a strength of an alpha male. So these are the essence of a man. So being Mr. Philippines, he has a sense of humor. When was his sense of humor is? Well, like him. He have a sense of humor, right? Am I right? Yes. Everyone loves, he's a good looking. He talk a lot, he have a sense of humor, and like him, he is a Mr. Philippines and he's representing before because he have a sense of humor, doesn't he?
Okay, thank you, candidate number 8.
Bachelor number
21
from Pangasinan, Woody Andres Jr. So Woody, your name is very interesting. Why are you named Woody? But anyway,
because his parents called him Woody. Have you got a problem with that?
No, I'm just
curious. Why were you called Gab?
I'm just curious.
Why were you called
Gab? I can
tell
you that, but I'm just asking Woody over here. Why is your name Woody, by the way?
My name is Woody because it was followed by my father's name. His name is Woody also.
Okay, simple as that. And I like your name. I like your name.
So it says here that a Mr. Philippines should be humble.
A Mr. Philippines should be humble because he is an inspiration and motivation to everyone. A title will be only a title if it is projected in good and humble manner. So if I will win tonight, my reign will be only 1 year. So 1 year, but my image will be forever. So I will stay be humble, and if I do so, I will make a difference. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Candidate number 21, who we got next partner?
All right, so we also have Bachelor number 1, Aljun Kayawan from Agusan del Sur. Or actually, we are done with our other half of the top 15.
Okay, so let's bring it up. Thank you very much to the other candidates. Okay, number 1. I love your shirt.
Thank you so much. It's a Manubo-inspired barong. I am a prince of Manubo tribe, but it's an honor to be here.
Wow. Funny you should say that. My business partner is also part of the Manubo tribe. He was sent a certificate in Australia because he's half Australian. Fantastic. Wow. What a small world. Okay, are you ready for your question?
Yes, I am.
Okay, let's do this. Manubo tribe.
Mr. Philippines should be a man of goodwill. What is your take on that, Aljun?
To be Mr. Philippines, you should be an inspiration and a good role model to everyone. You can touch people, you can share a story, you inspire them, and in that way, you can be an ambassador of a goodwill. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Bachelor number 1, and now this is now the next set, or the last set of our top 16. So we now have Bachelor number 5 from Cabanatuan, Eris Godoy.
So what are you going to do first if you win tonight?
Una ko pong gagawin eh, syempre magpapasalamat po ako sa ating Panginoon.
What's the second thing you're going to do tonight?
Pangalawa po ay gagawin ko po ang mga dapat gawin bilang isang Mr. Philippines.
What's the third thing you're gonna do?
Ang pangatlo ko pong gagawin ay i-ready po ang aking sarili sa mga responsibilities na aking kakaharapin.
Okay, good job.
He's prepared.
He is prepared. He knows. He has a plan. He knows what he's going to do. Okay.
So Mr. Philippines should be socially responsible.
Ang isang Mr. Philippines ay dapat maging isang socially responsible. Gaya po ako, isa po akong isa po ako sa mga kalahok ngayon sa patimpalak na ito at sa aking palagay, ginagamit ko po ang Facebook para sa ganon ay maging ma-inspired ko yung mga kabataan sa kanilang buhay at ginagamit ko po ito upang maipakita sa kanila ang aking mga ginagawa sa aking buhay just like this. Ipinapost ko po ito sa Facebook para makita po nila na ako po ay isang mabuting tao at gayahin po nila yon. Yun lang po at maraming salamat.
Thank you very much,
Eric. Thank you very much.
Well said. And socially responsible.
Yes.
Andrew.
Through social media.
Through social media. Yes. Next is Bachelor number 22 from San Antonio Nueva. I see how we have Mark Anthony Beltran.
Okay, how are you feeling tonight?
Masaya po. At nakapasok sa top 15.
And how was the preparation leading up to tonight? Was it difficult? Did you work out a lot?
Workout and sobrang diet.
Super diet.
Okay, what are you gonna eat afterwards? McDonald's, Jollibee? Okay, minute burger tayo after. Is there one here?
There is.
Fantastic. Buy one, take one.
So Mr. Philippines should be a law-abiding citizen.
Naniniwala po ako na ang Mr. Philippines ay dapat ay law-abiding citizen. Dahil kung hindi niyo po, kung ang Mr. Philippines hindi niya kayang sundin ang batas, ang mga simpleng batas, papaano pa ang responsibilidad ng pagiging isang Mr. Philippines? Yun lang.
Thank you very much.
So that was Bachelor number 22.
22.
And we now move forward to Bachelor 19. Mark Ian Camelet from Magalang, Pampanga.
So there's a fan club over there on the right.
Just lives nearby.
Do you have a message to your fans out there?
Thank you po sa lahat ng bumunta. Mark, I love you po.
He's so sweet. Hashtag sweet. Sweet candidate.
Alright, so the trait that you have is that a Mr. Philippines should be healthy and fit.
A Mr. Philippines should be healthy and fit because you and his fellow Filipino will look up to him on how she grew, on how she developed his achievement and how he developed his achievement and his goals and to set an inspiration. As an ambassador of goodwill, as an ambassador of health, of being healthy and being fit. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you very much. You have to be an inspiration and aspirational.
Overall.
Yes.
An overall athlete.
As a winner.
So now we have Bachelor number 16, Arjoy Albanbuena from La Union. It's like a teen heart.
Okay, who? Another tall guy. I need to stand. I need to tiptoe. So, who did you come with tonight?
My family, my supporters, and my cousin.
Is there a lucky lady out there this evening?
None. Only my supporters.
Okay, that's good because you wouldn't be a bachelor otherwise. Just checking.
All right. So, Arjoy, what? Having. Alright, so Arjoy, Mr. Philippines should be patriotic.
Mr. Philippines should be patriotic because We have an attitude to serve our country, and I am the one of the candidate that I have a passion, love for our country. So if I win and I get a title here in competition, I definitely serve because I love my country. Thank you.
Thank you much. Good answer, candidate number 16.
And now let's have bachelor number 24, Cyrus Morris from San Pablo, Laguna.
Look at that smile, Colgate smile. Give this man a contract. Why have you got such a good smile?
Yes.
It's not the dentist, it's your parents. Okay.
So Cyrus, tick.
Sakin, I had braces.
You had braces when you were young. Okay, so Cyrus, Mr. Philippines should be a leader.
Magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat, sa mga rata ko. Bilang isang Mr. Philippines, leader tayo. Maging role model tayo sa mga kabataan ngayon tulad namin. Na kung saan pwede natin ma-impluensyahan at matulungan ng mga kabataan ngayon tulad namin mga kabataan na kung saan naliligaw ng landas. At maging role model sa lahat ng mga gandang bagay na pwedeng pasukin at lahat ng bagay na pwedeng subukin at malampasan para makamit natin ang tagumpay. Should be a leader. Be a Mr. Philippines.
Thank you very much.
It's really nice to hear what their thoughts on these traits are. Thank you very much, Bachelor 24.
That could be a slogan. Be a leader. Be Mr. Philippines. We could use that.
Yes. Why don't we use it next year?
Yeah.
Maybe. Okay, so Bachelor number 12 is next. David Joshua Soledad from Florida Blanca, Pampanga. Sheer.
Okay. Are you ready for your question?
Yes.
So am I.
So David.
Go for your trait.
Philippines should be an achiever.
Kailangan pong yung Mr. Philippines maging achiever para mapakita niya sa mga tao na hindi kadlang ang panghihirap para ma-achieve niya yung mga gusto niya. Kailangan kahit mahirap na yung bagay na pinasok mo, tapusin mo kasi inumpisan mo, kailangan gawin mo yung kaya mo hanggang sa huli.
Alright, so thank you very much.
Never give up.
And now we are down to two.
Yes.
We have, actually these two are the ones that tied up a while ago. So we have Ivan Daryl Francisco, bachelor number 10, from the Filipino community of Dubai.
From Dubai. So what, are you based there at the moment?
In there at Dubai. In
so how long have you been there?
I was born in Bahrain and raised in Dubai for 18 years. It's my first time here in the Philippines, actually.
No way! Welcome to the Philippines! Fantastic!
First time that you're representing the Filipino community of Dubai.
That's great, I love this.
Alright, so Ivan, Mr. Philippines should be optimistic. What is your take on this?
My take on this is we have struggles and difficulties in life, but always pray, always be hopeful that better things are yet to come. Thank you.
Short but meaty. Thank you very much, Bachelor number 10.
Thank you very much.
And lastly, we have Bachelor number 9 from Cotabato, Omar Kayam Ampang.
Okay, I've already pulled it up for you because this is the last one. And why has a Mr. Philippines be willing, why should he be willing to serve? Willing to serve.
Good evening, everyone. Being willing to serve to others is the qualities of being a true Mr. Philippines. If you're willing to serve to others, your heart will be in your mind, in your heart. Well, thank you.
Okay, thank you very much.
All right, so there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, our top 16.
Yes, give them a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.